Hey everyone! In my previous videos, we looked at how to customize the FlipperZero main menu icons and entries. In this video, we'll look at how to customize the look and feel of the main menu. For this tutorial, we're going to replace the existing main menu, where you can currently see three items that we can scroll up and we can scroll down, with a new menu module that lets us scroll to the right and to the left. Let's get started. The code for the menu module is under Applications, Services, GUI, Modules, and then menu.c. In menu.c, the menu item has a label, an icon, an index, a callback to invoke, and a context for that callback. This is where you'd add any additional properties that you need to render your menu item. The menu model has the list of items, and it has a position, which is the selected item. You can extend menu model if you need additional properties to render your UI. The code currently has callbacks for process up, process down, and process OK. We're going to want to change that to be process right, process left, and process OK. A little bit later in the video, we'll look at this menu draw callback, which does all the rendering of our menu. We'll end up probably replacing the majority of this code since our layout looks dramatically different. In menu input callback, we want to change the code. So input key right instead of up, and it should call menu process right. And then instead of input key down, we'll say input key left, and it should call menu process left. And then scrolling down a little bit, we see for repeat, we have up, so we'll change that to right, and process right. And then input key down, we'll switch to input key left, and menu process left. So menu enter gets invoked when we display the menu. And this is going to get the current selected item and call icon animation start animating the currently selected icon. We still want to do that. And the menu exit gets invoked when we leave the menu. This is going to get the current selected icon and call stop on it. And we still want to do that. Menu alloc is going to allocate our view, set the context, allocate our model, set our draw and input, enter and exit callbacks. It's going to initialize our menu item array and set the position to 0. And then it'll return the menu. Menu free does a menu reset, and then it clears the items out of the menu and frees the resources. Get view just returns our view. And then menu add item creates a new item and sets the label, the icon, the index, the callback, and the callback context. If your items need additional properties, you'd set those here. And then menu reset is going to go through and stop and free each of the animations, reset the list, and set the position to 0. And set selected item is just going to change our position to the index that's selected. Instead of menu process up, we go ahead and say menu process right. That's going to grab the current item and call stop. And then, oh, it's decrementing. So actually we want to decrement the index of our position when it's left. So we'll say menu process left here. And so if the position is bigger than 0, we're going to decrement it by 1. Otherwise, we're going to set the position to the last item in the list, which is the size of the list minus 1, since it starts at 0. And then we're going to get the item and call start so that the selected item starts animating. And then instead of process down, we're going to say process right. And then right is going to get the current item and stop animations, increment our position. If we're already at the end of the list, it's going to set the position to the front of the list. It's going to get the current item, and then it's going to start animating the icon. process OK is going to get the current item. And then if there's a callback, it will call that callback, passing the callback context and the index of the item. That's the end of the file. So Control Shift B, and then choose Flash USB without resources. We'll press OK to bring up the menu, and now we'll use the right to move further down the list, and then we'll use the left to move back on the list. You'll also notice that up button and down button no longer work, and that's because now we're using left and right. Now that navigation's working, we'll work on rendering. So go into menu draw callback. This code clears the canvas. It gets the current position and item count. And if the item count is not zero, then it draws the first line and the second line and the third line and then the frame and scroll bars. Our UI doesn't use frame and scroll bar, so we can go ahead and remove that code. So going back to the top of the if statement, shift position is the index in the menu item array for the item we're trying to render. This should be a number between 0 and count minus 1. The first parameter is the spot. 0, 1, and 2 is the first line, second line, third line. And then we have position. That's the selected item. And then we have items count. This is the total number of items. And then we have minus 1, which is the number of items to show before the selected position. So we want to say minus 3. So we'll show 3 items, and then our selected item, and then 3 more items. And I'll go ahead and update that next shift position formula as well. And then we can go ahead and delete the code for the first line since we won't be needing that, and we won't be needing the third line either. I forgot to say percent items count divides the result by items count and returns the remainder, which will be a number between 0 and items count minus 1. Animated icons are 14 by 14. So we'll draw each icon 16 pixels apart, so we get a little bit of gap on each side. So let's go ahead and make a uint 8 underscore t, and we'll call this icon x, and we'll set that to 1 pixel over to start with. Next, we'll do a for loop, and we'll say size t as the size, and then we'll say I equals 0, I is less than 7, I plus plus, so I increments by 1 each time. So I'll go ahead and accept the AI autocomplete. We can change it in a second. Okay, so shift position is I plus position plus items count minus 3 modulo items count, so that's good. And then we get the current item at the shift position, and then we draw the icon at X and 25. I'd like to change that to 32. Since our screen is 64 pixels high, 32 is halfway. And then we'll change icon X to increment by 16. After we get the item, we'll add an if check. If I equals equals 3, then we're on the big item that we want. So we'll go ahead and grab this canvas set font, font primary. And then we will do a canvas drawstring as well. I like to actually use drawstring aligned. So if you use drawstring aligned, you're able to say the centering. We'll go ahead and set the X position to 64. Since our screen is 128 wide, that's the midpoint. And then 64 is the height of our screen. And then we'll say align center. And then we'll do an align bottom. So that'll draw our selected item at the center bottom of the screen. And then we'll go ahead and say icon underscore X plus equals 8 pixels. So we'll move 8 pixels before we start to draw that icon. So that'll give us a little bit of a gap. And then let me go ahead and copy this after we've drawn the icon and delete these lines. And after drawing the icon, when I is 3, we'll also put an 8 pixel gap. So that'll just make that center icon stand out a little more. And now we can go ahead and delete the bottom of the code that we're not using anymore, just the for loop. And Control Shift B, and then choose Flash USB without resources. That'll take a moment. Oh, it looks like we have a compiler error. The fourth argument's not compatible, and that's because it should be canvas draw icon animation. Control Shift B, Flash USB without resources. So in this case, it looks like the copilot used the wrong method. So once that's deployed, we'll press the OK button. And then we'll go ahead and scroll through some of these menu items. Great. And so I think one thing that would make it look better is if the icon was raised up a little bit here, if it was a little bit higher. So let's go do that. So currently we draw all the icons at that 32 pixel height. We'll go ahead and add a new variable and we'll call this icon Y and we'll set its default to 32. And then when I equals equals 3, we'll go ahead and change the Y to 24. We'll update our hard-coded 32 to use icon underscore Y. And then after we've drawn it, we'll switch it to icon Y back to 32. And then Control Shift B, and then Flash USB without resources. And then we'll go ahead and press OK. And go ahead and scroll through those menu items. Currently, shift position has a bug. If I was 0 and position is 0, then that's 0 plus 0. If items count was 2, 0 plus 0 plus 2 minus 3 is negative 1. And what we actually want is a positive value modulo items count. So I'm going to go ahead and modify that to be 8 times the items count. So now shift position will always be a positive number. And since we take that result and divide it by items count and use the remainder, adding 7 times more items count when we divide it by items count doesn't change the answer. Control Shift B and then Flash USB without resources. Then I'll go ahead and click OK and we'll scroll over. Oh, and I just noticed that this text is clipping here. So we probably need to move the text up a little bit. We can probably move it up like 4 pixels, somewhere in there should be right. So instead of 64, we'll switch that value to 60 for the Y, Control Shift B and Flash USB. Go ahead and press OK and scroll back over to that text that was clipping. Yep, and that looks great. So I hope you found this video on customizing the look and feel of the Flipper Zero main menu helpful. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.